أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. Now we are at the last section or last ruku of Surah Al-Hajj. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الناس ضرب مثل فاستمعوا له إن الذين تدعون من دون الله لن يخلقوا ذبابا ولو اجتمعوا له وإن يسلبهم الذباب شيئا لا يستنقذوه منه ضعف الطالب والمطلوب ما قدر الله حق قدره إن الله لقوي عزيز. الله يصطفي من الملائكة رسلا ومن الناس إن الله سميع بصير يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم وإلى الله ترجع الأمور. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اركعوا واسجدوا واعبدوا ربكم وافعلوا الخير لعلكم تفلحون. وجاهدوا في الله حق جهاده هو اجتباكم وما جعل عليكم في الدين من حرج ملة أبيكم إبراهيم هو سماكم المسلمين من قبل وفي هذا ليكون الرسول شهيدا عليكم وتكونوا شهداء على الناس فأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة واعتصموا بالله هو مولاكم فنعم المولى ونعم النصير. صدق الله العظيم. As I said before, this is one of the most profound places of the Quran. As I said last night, it's the general rule with the surahs of Quran that the ayat with which a surah begins and the ayat with which a surah ends, they are usually very comprehensive, very profound. And this is a very outstanding example. The first section of this surah was most profound about resurrection. Ya ayyuha an-nas, in kuntum fi raybin min al-ba'ts, fa'inna khalaqnakum min turabin, summa min nutfatin, summa min alaqatin, and so on and so forth. And this is actually a summary of the call of Quran, which we find in these six ayat of the last section. But here this call of Quran has been divided into two parts. One part of the call of Quran is for the all mankind, Hindus, Sikhs, Christians, anybody. Because Muhammad was sent for the whole of humanity, not for Arabs. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةَ لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَزِيرًا. Now this call is for Iman. To them we can't say you should pray. He must first believe in Allah. He must first believe in the resurrection. He must believe in revelation. He must believe in Quran. He must believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then we can say you should pray. You should fast. So any invitation for any action or deed is for the believers who say we believe. So these are two parts. Those people who don't believe, who are outside the pale of Islam, they are addressed here, Ya Yuhannas, O mankind. In four ayat, the basic three articles of faith, Tawheed versus Shirk, then Iman bil Risalah, institution of messengerhood, and then Qiyamah and resurrection. These are the basic things which must be accepted by a person to be able to be addressed as Ya Ayyuhal Lazeena Amanu. But then the last two ayat, they are Ya Ayyuhal Lazeena Amanu. Now the call is for action. Whosoever says I believe in Allah and in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and in Quran and in resurrection, now he has to do something. So the first call is the call to Quran, to Iman, and this is for the whole mankind. The second part of call is the call of action. But here they are addressed who say we believe. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu duriba masalun fastami'u lah. Now those who don't believe, at that time they were the worshippers of the idols. So to them a similitude is being struck. O mankind, a similitude is struck. So listen it attentively. فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ سَمِعَ يَسْمَعُوا to listen and istama يَسْتَمِعُوا to listen attentively. This is the word which appears in Quran in Surah Al-Araf. فَإِذَا قُرِيَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ. When Quran is recited, you must listen to it very attentively. What is that similitude? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. These idols, these gods, whom you are calling upon besides Allah, لَنْ يَخْلُقُوا زُبَابًا. They can't even create a fly. What to speak of the creation of these heavens and earth and this moon and sun? لَنْ يَخْلُقُوا زُبَابًا وَلِمِشْتَمَرُوا. Although they might gather together, all of them, but they can't create. Creator is only one. And this they accepted. وَلَنْ سَالْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. If you ask them, who created the heavens and earth? They will say Allah. They didn't say that these idols or these, you know, Lat, Manat, Uzza, they have created the world. Creator, they accepted, he was Allah only. وَلَئِنْ يَسْلُمْهُمُ الزُّبَابُ شَيْئًا. And if the fly snatches away something from them, لَا يَسْتَنْقِذُوهُ مِنْهُ. They cannot take it back from them. ضَعُفَ الطَّالِبُ وَالْمَطْلُوبُ. Very feeble is indeed the seeker and the sought. Now these three words, Zawfa Talib wal Matloob, they are most basically philosophical words. Every human being has some ideal in his life. And if a human being doesn't have an ideal in his life, some goal in life, some aim, some rasmul ayn, then he is just like animals, he is not a human being at all. The animals don't have any aim of life. You are using them, you are exploiting them. But the human beings, if he is a real human being, he has a goal. He has fixed some ideal for him. Some adarsh, in Hindi they say adarsh. Nasmulayan in Arabic. Some goal, some ideal. Now, if the ideal is low, that man will also be low in character. The ideal is high, the character of that person will also rise. Corresponding, if the ideal is low, then you are low in morality. If your ideal is high, you yourself go up in morality and character. ضَعُفَ الطَّالِبُ وَالْمَطْلُوبُ. Now actual matloob is Allah. You must love Him. He is the matloob. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. As we have in Surah Al-Baqarah. Those who believe, they have the strongest love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the matloob. Who al matloob? La matlooba illallah, la maqsooda illallah, la mahmooba illallah. This is the crux of tawheed. La matlooba illallah. If Allah is matloob, your character will go up and up and up. Just like, so to say, the character of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His matloob was Allah. But whosoever has a lower ideal, then he will himself steep low in morality. مَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. They have not esteemed Allah with the true esteem due to Him. Now what concept we have of Allah? These mushrikeen, they thought He's a big king, okay? He's a big king. But the king has also, you know, there are ranks and files in the armies, and the king is nothing without the army. So, Allah has also some subordinates, and He needs their help. So that is the shirk that they have committed. Because they couldn't understand, they couldn't think that Allah can be so powerful that He doesn't need anybody. He can control the whole universe Himself. He has created angels, but not that because He needs them. He has created, but He can control the whole universe. Every moment, Himself. So Allah is very powerful, very powerful, omniscient, omnipotent. So there can be no higher ideal than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If somebody can esteem Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the true esteem, he will have him only as the ideal and matloob and nothing else. مَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَقَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. Verily, Allah is very powerful, strong, mighty. Now comes the second article of faith, and that is the institution of messengerhood. اللَّهُ يَسْتَفِي مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ رُسُلًا وَمِنَ النَّاسِ. Now this messengership of Allah has two links. Allah has to send down His message to the common human beings. He takes two links. First of all, He gives His message to the angel. He is closer to Allah. He was created out of light. So Allah gives this message to whom? To the angel. Now angel brings it to the man who has been selected. Muhammad, for example, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So there are two messengers in between. Now Muhammad conveys the message to his fellow men, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So from Allah to these common people, there are two links in between. The one messenger is the angel. The other messenger, he is also a messenger. He has brought the message from Allah to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So messenger number one is the angel. Messenger number two is the messenger from among human beings. It was, sometimes it was Nuh, sometimes it was Hud, sometimes it was Saleh, sometimes it was Moses, sometimes it was Jesus, sometimes it is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah yastafi min al-malaikati rusulan wa min al-nas. Allah chooses from in angels also messengers and from mankind also. Inna Allah sami'un basir. Verily Allah is all seeing, all listening. Ya'lamu ma bayna yadihim wa ma khalfahum. He knows whatever is before them and whatever is in behind them. Wa ilallahi turja'ul umur. And all the matters will finally be returned to Allah for final judgment. This is resurrection and this is the day of judgment. So these are the three articles of faith which have been summarized here in four ayat. Tawheed versus shirk. Institution of messengerhood. This messengerhood continuing, being consisting of two links. The angel messenger and the man, human messenger. And then returning to the Lord for the final judgment and for the reward. Now the address comes to those who say we believe in these things. Now you and I, we are being addressed. Ya ayyuha allazeena amanu. Oh, those who believe, who profess to believe, who say, who claim that they believe in Allah and His unity, and they believe in the institution of messengerhood, and that Muhammad is the last messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Quran is the last message of Allah, and who believe in resurrection and the life hereafter. Now, there are commands for action. Ya ayyuha allazeena amanu irka'u, bow before your Lord. Wasjudu, prostrate before your Lord. Wa'budu rabbakum, and worship and be bondsmen to your Lord. I explained this ibadah. It has two elements, total obedience, and strong love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ruku, sujood. These are the two members of salah, our namaz, our prayer. But then, you should not only pray, you should not only fast, you should not only do the hajj. You have to obey Allah all of your life, all aspects. Your individual life, your collective life, your community life, your political life. Everywhere you have to be a bondsman to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ. Something more also. Do good deeds. Now the question can arise. The salah has been mentioned, ruku has come, sajda has come, and total obedience has come. Now what remains for which there is these words, وَفَلُوا الْخَيْرَ. You know, obedience is to the command that has been given. Do this, don't do this. This is obedience. Over and above that, if you devote yourself for the service of mankind, this is وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ. خَيْرُ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَنْفَعُ النَّاسِ. When you have paid zakah, well, you have done your duty. Obedience is okay. But no, spend more, give more. Till such time, retain with you only what is necessary for you. Don't retain anything which is extra, surplus with you. Give it away. So this is wafalul khair. This is not obligatory. This is voluntary. You can do it if you like. If you don't want, don't do it. But wafalul khair. But service of humanity. Now there are once I made a speech here in some hotel, in function of this very center. The service has three levels. Number one, you feed a hungry, it's a service to mankind. You arrange for treatment for a sick person, it's a service, okay? And this concept of service is common to all humanity. Hindus, Sikhs, Parsis, Isais, they all know. These are good deeds, everybody must do it. But then there is the service number two, and that is the real service. Try to save them from the fire of hell. If you have fed them here, the fire of hunger in their stomachs, you know, you have extinguished. But they are going to be thrown into the fire of hell forever. And you are not caring for that. So, dawa ilallah, call towards Allah, so that these people can be saved from the eternal fire of hell. That is the biggest service. This was the service. You know, that general service Muhammad was doing from the very beginning, before Wahi had started, to look after the orphans and the widows and to feed the hungry, that he was doing already. But after the Wahi started, now what was the service which he was doing? To save people from the fire of hell. Calling them toward the right path. Oh people, take to the right path. Come to Sirat-e-Mustaqim. Believe in Allah alone. Worship Him alone. So that you are saved from the doom in the hereafter. And the third level is to establish the just social order here in this world. You are feeding the hungry, good work. But why are they hungry? They are hungry due to the unjust distribution of wealth in your system. The wealth has been accumulated with certain people. And the rest are going hungry. Now you are feeding the hungry. But you are keeping that system as such. You must shatter this system. And you should establish the system of social justice. So that hunger is eliminated. Otherwise, how many hungry will you be able to feed? You must change this system. And this is called Iqamatuddin. To establish the system of social justice that has been given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the form of Deenul Haqq through Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So these are the three levels of service to humanity. Now you do these four things. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Only then you can hope to have salvation. Don't think that only because you say we believe you have the salvation. Oh no! تِلْكَ أَمَانِيُّهُمْ. They are, this is their wishful thinking. They have fabricated these aqaid for them. There is no guarantee from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Oh, you who believe, oh, you who profess to believe, bow before your Lord, prostrate before your Lord, be a total obedient and servant to Him, and do good deeds, so that you attain salvation. Now, if salvation can be attained without these things, this is meaningless passage then. This is conditional. وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلِ الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. The starting point of that selected course of study of Quran, which I mentioned in my last lecture, the basis is Suratul Asr. By the token of time, by the fleeing time, all mankind is doomed except those who come to believe and who do good deeds and who exhort each other, something which is true and good, and they exhort each other to persevere in the way of truth. Unless you fulfill these four conditions, you are doomed. In the same way, if you want to have the salvation, Ya ayyuha allazeena amanu rkau wasjudu wa'budu rabbakum wa'malu khaira la'allakum tuflihun. And this is not all. Wajahidu fillahi haqqa jihadi. And make jihad in the way of Allah. as much as is the right of Allah. He is your creator, he is your sustainer. Just imagine how much right he has over you. And how much are you working for him? And what is what this jihad for? To establish that system of social justice. Do you have to make jihad? These exploiters will never give up their exploitation. These oppressors are never ready to give up their oppression. These discriminators, they will never give up discrimination. You will have to fight them out. Muhammad had to fight them out. There can be no better preacher, no better teacher than Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he had to go to fight against those people. Otherwise, injustices cannot be finished. Exploitations cannot be put an end to. These things will continue. Jahidu fillahi haqqa jihadi. Make jihad in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As much as is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has chosen you who wajtabakum. Be merry. Rejoice. You are a chosen one. This ummah has been chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have read the ayah in Surah Al-Imran. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. Ta'muruna bil ma'roof wa tanhauna anil munkar. You have been raised for the purpose, for the benefit of the humanity at large. Your mission is to enjoin upon humanity whatever is correct, to forbid them from whatever is wrong and munkar. And you should have faith in Allah. He has selected you. You are the chosen one. This word ijtiba. And we have the word istifa. Allahu yastafi min al malaikati rusulan. We read it. And from istifa is the word Mustafa. Muhammad Mustafa. And for ijtiba is mujtaba. Ahmad mujtaba. This word is used for the messengers. So as an ummah, we are messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah sent his messenger Muhammad. And Muhammad assigned this messengerhood to us on the day of his last pilgrimage. When he said, now the burden has shifted from my shoulders to yours. فَلْيُبَلِّغِ شَاهِدُ الْغَائِبَ جَاهِدُوا فِي اللَّهِ حَقَّ جِهَادِهِ وَاجْتَبَاكُمْ He has selected you. وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ He has put no impediments in your way in religion. مِلَّةَ أَبِيكُمْ إِبْرَاهِيمِ Because the first addressees are who? Banu Ismail. So this deen which Muhammad has brought for you, well, this is the deen of Ibrahim, your grandfather. Abikum Ibrahim huwa sammakum al-Muslim. Allah has given you the name of Muslimin. You are the people who have surrendered themselves to the will of Allah. Min qablu wa fi haza, before also or here also. Liyakuna ar-rasulu shahidan alaykum. So that our messenger becomes witness against you. He will stand on the day of judgment and testify, O Allah, your message which came to me through Jibreel, I had conveyed to them. Now they are responsible. They are accountable. In the same way, you will be required to stand up and say, O Allah, the message which we received through Muhammad, we had conveyed it to the whole humanity. And if we fail to do it, then we are the culprits. The blame will come to us. People can sue us in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, they had your book. They claimed that they are the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But they never conveyed to us your message. Never. Rather, their own actions were just contrary. They were saying something else, doing something else. This is the position. لَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ شَهِيدًا عَلَيْكُمْ وَتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ فَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ So establish salah and zakah وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِاللَّهِ And cling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hold fast to Him. هُوَ مَوْلَاكُمْ He is your protector. فَنِعْمَ الْمَوْلَى How good a protector He is. فَنِعْمَ النَّصِيرُ How fine a helper he is. Now we come to the next surah, Al-Mu'minun. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The first section of this surah, rather half of it, is also one of the most important lessons of that selected course of study. It gives us the foundations on which the character of a true mu'min can be built. We have to build the character. unless we have the character of mu'mineen, we won't be able to work for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We won't be able to make jihad in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First of all, the individual character has to be on that pattern. What are the foundations on which this building of character, on seerah of a true mu'min can be built? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Verily, the believers have already attained salvation. Very good news. Who are those believers? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Who humble in their prayers. When they are praying, they are very humble. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. And those who keep away from vain things, useless things, what we call pastimes. Why? This time is very precious. Either it should be spent so that some need of this world is fulfilled. Need, real need. Or this time should be spent to earn something, some reward for the hereafter. Not to waste. To pass time is not a problem. This is the most precious capital we have. We have the only capital in this time that we have. Whatever we can make for the hereafter is in this time. So we can't waste it in vain things. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. And those who keep on doing zakat, because this surah revealed in early Makki period. So zakat here doesn't mean the institutional zakat, that is one of the pillars of Islam, but the process of zakat. Continually giving away alms to the needy, to the poor. This is continuous process of purification of yourselves and your wealth. If you have given the due of the poor, then your wealth is now pure. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ. And those who guard their private parts, their sexual urge, they control it. إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِمْ. Except in regard to their wives, أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ. Or those whom their right hands possess, the concubines, only two. Here, فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ. In this case, they are not blameworthy. Sex is not an evil in itself. It's only evil when some unlicensed, unpermitted way you adopt. Otherwise, with your wife, with your concubines, it's okay. No blame. It's not evil. It's not bad. It's a normal requirement of nature. It's the normal requirement of society. Just as you want to preserve yourself, you want to preserve your species. And this is the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed. فَمَنْ اِبْتَغَى وَرَىٰ ذَٰلِكَ. But whosoever exceeds from there, wife and concubines, and then he exceeds, goes somewhere else, that is adultery. فَمَنْ اِبْتَغَى وَرَىٰ ذَٰلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ. Then they are the transgressors. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَدِهِمْ رَعُونَ. And those who keep their trusts and covenants, guard them, whatever promise they have made, whatever amana, trust, they have been trusted with something, they guard them. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. Those who guard over their prayers at proper time, with proper, you know, method, establish in congregation, offering namaz, offering salah in congregation. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ. Such people will be the inheritors. Inheritors of what? الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسِ. Who will inherit the gardens of paradise. هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. And they will live in them forever, forever. Now come these ayat, which in the first section of Suratul Hajj also. إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ عَلَقَةٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ مُضْغَةٍ مُخَلَّقَةٍ وَغَيْرَ مُخَلَّقَةٍ. This process, this embryonic process, the process of embryology. And this is the most important place in Quran for the description of these stages of evolution of a human fetus. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ تِينَ. And we have created man out of the extract of mud. The mud is extract. Whatever we eat, where from is it coming? From the mud. So, this is the extract of the mud that is giving us power, strength, energy. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينٍ. Then the next stage was, we put him as a sperm drop in the safe lodging of the wall of the womb of the mother. Now it is there for some time. ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً. Then we create from this nutfa alaqa. Now this word had been translated till this time as a clot. But there's no basis of this translation. Alaqa. Alaqa is something which is mu'allaq. Hanging. Mu'allaq ho jana. Hanging. Because now the next stage is that it is attached to the wall of the womb of the mother just as a leech. Hanging. This is alaqa. This is the third stage. That is why, you know, these embryologists in Toronto University, and they wrote it, that these stages, as they are described in Quran, it's wonderful. They could never see it. Imagine that 1400 years ago, when there were no microscopes, no dissections, how this description has been able. Dr. Keith L. Moore, his textbook on embryology is read all the world over, and he says this. ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَةَ مُضْغَةً. And then this alaqa, we create out of it a lump of flesh. فَخَلَقْنَا الْمُضْغَةَ عِظَامًا. From this lump of flesh, we create bones. فَقَصَوْنَا الْعِظَامَ اللَّحْمَ. And then we clothe these bones with flesh, with muscles. ثُمَّ أَنْشَانَاهُ خَلْقًا آخِرٌ. And then we raise him to another creation. What is this another creation? خَلْقًا آخر. Because at this stage, the angel is sent, and the ruh, the spirit that was there in the stores, in the alame habr, that ruh is brought by the angel, and now blown into this fetus. Now it is human being. Before that, it was a living creature, not a human being. Adam, when was created, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. He passed through all the stages of creation. And then all the finishing touches were given to him. Then when Allah blew into him from his own spirit, now he became Adam. And this process is repeated in the womb of the mother, every human child. This is a hadith from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى عنه, muttafaqun alayhi, Bukhari, Muslim, both. The Prophet said, for 40 days, you are a sperm, nutfa. Another 40 days, you are alaqa. Another 40 days, you are muzgha. After 120 days, Allah sends, فَيُرْسَلُ الْمَلَكُ. The angel is sent, فَيَنْفَخُ فِيهِ الْرُوحِ. And he blows into it, the ruh. The ruh doesn't mean life. It was not dead matter. Already it was a living matter. Very much living. The sperm was very much living, very mobile, very active. And even the ovum that has come from the mother's side is a living thing. So in all these stages, for 120 days, it was not a dead thing, dead matter. It was living. But it was not human. Till such time that the angel comes, and then he blows and joins that ruh with it. And here Quran says, ثُمَّ أَنْشَانَاهُ خَلْقًا آخَرٌ. Now another creation which we have taken. فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. So Allah is best of the creators and bless it. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ لَمَيَّتُونَ. Then after this, all of you will have to die. You have come in this world. But then, that is to come. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تُبْعَثُونَ. Then there will come a day of resurrection, when you will be raised again. So this is so simple. If he could create you from dust, can't he create you again? The sequence, you know, it itself shows it's nothing. It's just logical. Whosoever has done this up till now, he can do this also. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبْعَ تَرَائِبَ. And we have built over you seven heavens. وَمَا كُنَّا عَنِ الْخَلْقِ غَارِفِلُونَ. And we have never been unaware of our makhluk, of our creation. We know each and everything of the creation. وَأَنزَلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً بِقَدَرٍ. And we send down water from the heaven in a measure, with an estimated amount. فَأَسْكَنَّاهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And then make it settle in the land, in the earth. وَإِنَّا عَلَىٰ ذَهَابٍ بِهِ لَقَادِرُونَ. And we are powerful, we can take it away from you whenever we like. This water, which is going to be a very big problem, shortage of water, that time is soon coming. These famines and droughts, how many droughts in India, or in many countries, water is going to be a problem. If Allah takes it away, who will bring it back? We are very much powerful, we can take it away from you. But then, with this water, we have raised for you the gardens of palm dates and you know, vines and grapes. لَكُمْ فِيهَا فَوَاكِهَا كَثِيرَةً. In these things you have many fruits. وَمِنْهَا تَعْكُلُونَ. And also food. You eat out of them. وَشَجَرَةً تَخْرُجُ مِنْ تُورِ سَيْنَا. And that tree which comes out from the Mount of Sina, that is olive tree, with duhun, it grows with oil. The olive oil. It is coming from a tree. وَسِمْغٍ لِلْآكِلِينَ. And it is a sauce for the eaters. They used to eat, you know, their bread, touch it with this olive oil and eat it. It was just like, you know, a sauce. وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ فِي الْأَنْعَامِ الْعِبْرَةِ. And there is for you a lesson in your cattle. نُسْقِيكُمْ مِمَّا فِي بُطُونِهَا. We give you to drink from what is in their bellies. The milk, where does it come from? From their bellies. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَنَافِعُ كَثِيرَةٌ. And you have so many purposes fulfilled through these cattle. وَمِنْهَا تَعْكُلُونَ. And some of them you eat, their meat. That's a source of protein for you. وَعَلَيْهَا وَعَلَى الْفُلْكِ تُحْمَلُونَ. And on these cattle and on the ships you are carried. You are carried by the horses, by the camels, mules and donkeys and these boats and ships. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ. And we had sent Nuh to his nation. فَقَالَ يَا قَوْمِ عِبُدُ اللَّهَ. And he said to them, O my people, worship Allah, مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. You don't have any other God except him. أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Don't you fear Allah? فَقَالَ الْمَلَوُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَوْمِهِ. The chieftains from his nation, from his people, who disbelieved him, said, مَا هَذَا إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. Oh people, this Nuh is not nothing but a bashar, a man, a mortal man, human being like you. يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَتَفَضَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ. He wants to be superior over you, so that you believe him, and he becomes your leader and ruler. So he is ambitious. He wants power. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَأَنزَلَ مَلَائِكَةً. If Allah had to send some messenger, he could send some angel. It means they believed in Allah. Because they were mushriks, you know. Who is a mushrik? A mushrik is the one who believes in the Allah, the big Allah, the great Allah, and Aliha, small Allahs with them, small Ilah with them. The God with capital G, God, omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent. But gods and goddesses with small G, numberless, numerous. This is the game. Mahadev, one. Devis and Devatas, Beshumar, endless. So, مَا سَمِعْنَا بِهَذَا فِي آبَائِنَا الْأَوَّلِينَ. Had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to send a messenger, he could send an angel. And we have not heard about these things in our forefathers, what this Nuh is saying. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا رَجُلٌ بِهِ جِنَّةٌ. We think that this is a person, either he has been possessed by jinns, or some madness has come to him. فَتَرَبَّسُ. So just wait, see what happens with him. Don't, you know, accept him and don't believe in him hastily. فَتَرَبَّسُ بِهِ حَتَّاعِينَ. For a while you wait. قَالَ رَبِّنْ سُرْنِي بِمَا كَذَّبُونَ. Nuh prayed to Allah, oh Allah help me, because they have belied me. power hai na ilahi. So we send the revelation to him. And Israel fulka bi ayunina wahilna. Make an ark according to our wahi, revelations. We shall give instructions how to build it. And in our before our eyes, you build it. Faiza ja amruna. When our command comes, wafarat tanur, and the oven boils up, fasluk fiha. Then enter, make enter in this ark of yours. Min kulli zawjain isnain. A pair, two from every kind. Wa'ahlaka, and your family also. Illa man sabaqa alayhi al-qawl minhum. Except against whom the word has already gone forth. Your son, he's kafir, he won't come here. One of your wives, kafir, she won't be entered here. وَلَا تُخَاطِبْنِي فِي الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. And now don't address me, don't talk to me about those people who are, have wronged themselves. إِنَّهُمْ مُغْرَقُونَ. Now they are going to be drowned, all of them. فَإِذَا اسْتَوَيْتَ أَنْتَ وَمَنْ مَعَكَ عَلَى الْفُلْكِ. When you are settled, you and those who are with you on the ark, فَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي نَجَّانَا مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Then say, all praise be to Allah who has delivered us from these evil-doing people. وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَنزِلْنِي مُنزَلًا مُبَارَكًا. And then pray to Allah. O Allah, cause me to land a blessed landing. When this ark and this, you know, ship or boat comes to land somewhere, it should be a blissful and blessed landing. Now just remember the dua which was taught to Muhammad. وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَدْخِلْنِي مُدْخَلَ صِدْقٍ وَأَخْرِجْنِي مُخْرَجَ صِدْقٍ وَاجْعَلْنِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ سُلْطَانًا نَصِيرًا. It's very parallel. أَنزِلْنِي مَنْزِلًا مُبَارَكًا. O Allah, may cause me to land at a blessed landing. And you are the best of those who bring to land. In the فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ وَإِنْ كُنَّا لَمُبْتَلِينَ. In these, in this are the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have been surely we have been testing humanity from the very beginning. فَرْسَلْنَا ثُمَّ أَنْشَنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ قَرْنًا آخَرِينَ. After them, we raised another generation. فَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهِمْ رَسُولًا مِنْهُمْ. And then we sent our messenger in them also. Here name is not taken, but he is Hazrat Hud alayhi salatu wasalam, who was sent to the nation of Aad. أَنَيْبُدُ اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. The same message he conveyed. You should worship and obey Allah, and you don't have any God except Him. أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. So, don't you fear Him? وَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ. And the chieftains from His nation also said, الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, who had disbelieved Him, وَكَذَّبُوا بِلِقَاءِ الْآخِرَةِ. And they have denied that they are going to, they have to meet their Lord in the hereafter. وَأَتْرَفْنَاهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. And we had given them wealth, affluence in this worldly life. What did you say? مَا هَذَا إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. This Hud is nothing but a mortal human being like you. يَاكُلُ مِمَّا تَاكُلُونَ. He eats the same food which you eat. وَيَشْرَبُ مِمَّا تَشْرَبُونَ. And he drinks from which you drink. وَلَئِنْ أَطَعْتُمْ بَشَرًا مِثْلَكُمْ. And if you obey and follow a man like you, إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا لَخَاسِرُونَ. Then you are the losers. Well, we have the right, you should obey us. But don't obey this Hud or Nuh or Saleh. أَيَعِدُكُمْ أَنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِتُّمْ وَكُنْتُمْ تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا. Does he promise with you that when you are dead and you have become dust and bones, إِنَّكُمْ مُخْرَجُونَ, you will again be taken out as living from your graves? هَيْهَاتَ هَيْهَاتَ لِمَا تُوَعَدُونَ. Unbelievable, unbelievable. What promise is being given to you? إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا. There is no life for us except the life of this world. نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا. We ourselves die, we ourselves live. وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَبْعُوسِينَ. And we are not going to be resurrected. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا رَجُلٌ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. This fellow, this Hud, alayhi salatu wasalam, he is but a person who has forged lies against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا نَحْنُ لَهُ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. And we are not going to believe in him. قَالَ رَبِّ انصُرْنِي بِمَا كَذَّبُونَ. The same prayer Hazrat Hud made to Allah, O Allah, help me, because they have belied me. قَالَ عَمَّا قَلِيلٍ فَلَا يُصْبِحُنَّ نَادِمِينَ. Allah said, okay, in a very little while, they will be repentant on, and they will become repentant on what they have been doing. فأخذتهم الصيحة بالحق. So they were seized by a shout with truth. فجعلناهم غصاء. And we made them all this scum, like scum. فبعدا لقوم الظالمين. So away for this evil doing people. ثم انشانا من بعدهم قرون آخرين. Then we raised after them other generations. ما تسبق من أمة أجلها وما يستأخرون. No ummat could hasten the term that Allah had fixed for them, nor it could delay it, the time, promised time. When that came, they were destroyed. ثم أرسلنا رسلنا تترى. Then we kept on sending our messengers one by one, one after the other. متواتر تترى. كلما جاء أمة رسولها, whenever a messenger came to any people, كذبوه, they denied him, belied him. فأتبعنا بعضهم بعضا. So we sent them one after the other. We destroyed them one after the other. وجعلناهم أحاديث. And now we have made them stories and history. There was a nation called Aad, and there was a nation called Subud, and there was the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah, and there was a nation called Madian. Now all they are stories. ثم أرسلنا موسى وأخاه هارون بآياتنا وسلطان مبين. And then, in the end, we may say, we sent Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام and his brother Harun with our signs, miracles, وسلطان مبين and clear authority. إلى فرعون وملئه, to Pharaoh and his chieftains. فاستكبروا, they became arrogant. وكانوا قوما عالين, and they were very self exalting people. فقالوا, they said, أنؤمنوا لبشرين مثلنا? Shall we believe in two persons, two human beings who are just like us? وقومهما لنا عابدون. And their nation, their community is slave to us. They belong to our slave nation. They belong to Bani Israel, Musa and Harun. And this Bani Israel are slaves. How come they stand before us and say, obey us? We are the messengers of Allah. We are the representatives of your Lord. You have to obey us. Who are they? They are the people of our slave nation. وَقَوْمُهُمَا لَنَا عَابِدُونَ فَكَذَّبُوهُمَا. So they belied both of them. فَكَانُوا مِنَ الْمُهْلَكِينَ. But then they became from those, among those who were destroyed and finished. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَهْتَدُونَ. But then we gave Musa the book, Torah, so that the people take to the right path. وَجَعَلْنَا ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ وَأُمَّهُ آيَةً. And in the same way, we made Maryam, Salamun Alayha, Ibn Maryam, son of Maryam, وَأُمَّهُ and his mother, Hazrat Isa and Hazrat Maryam, آيَةً. We made them also a sign. وَأَوَيْنَاهُمَا إِلَىٰ رَبْوَةٍ ذَاتِ قَرَارٍ وَمَعِينٍ. And we gave them refuge, shelter, on a mount, on a hillock, where there was running springs. Ya ayyuhar rusul, O our messengers, kulu min at-tayyibat, eat from whatever is pure, wa'amalu saliha, and do good deeds. Inni bima ta'amaluna alim. Whatever you are doing, we know it, I know it. Wa inna hadhihi ummatukum ummatan wahida. And this is the ummah of all of you, and this is one ummah. All the messengers belong to one ummah. They were all Muslims. They were all messengers of Allah. They were all obedient to Allah. وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَعْبُدُونَ فَاتَّقُونَ. And I am your Lord, so fear me only. فَتَقَطَّعُوا أَمْرَهُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ زُبُرًا. So they split their matter, that is religion, between them, into different forms. كُلُّ حِزْبٍ بِمَا لَدَيْهِمْ فَرِحُونَ. And every sect is proud of what it has. One reality broken into pieces. One piece is with him, one piece is with him. And everybody is rejoicing that I have the total reality, while they have the partial realities with them. فَذَرْهُمْ فِي غَبْرَتِهِمْ حَتَّاهِمْ. So Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, leave them in their bewilderment for a time. أَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّمَا نُمِدُّهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ مَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. Do they think that actually We are assisting them when we are giving them wealth and sons. Nusare ulahum fil khairat, they think that we are giving them good. Nay, bal la yasharu, they don't know. Because actually this is wealth and these sons, they will become the basis of their chastisement in this world. We have twice this mazmoon, you know, in Surah Tawbah, this subject has come. Innama yuridu Allahu liyu'azzibahum biha fil hayati dunya wa tazhaqa anfusuhum wa hum kafirun. So don't be impressed by the wealth and the bodies of these munafiqeen, twice in Surah Tawbah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to give them the chastisement and punishment in this world. By this wealth, you have much wealth. Now you have lost some and you are gone, despaired. You have incurred a loss. You had a son, he died, and you are despaired. Maybe the son has gone astray. Now he is against you. He is standing before you and you call it, conversing with you at equal level. And you, how grieved you are. He is my son. I raised him. And today he is talking with me as equal, rather my superior. So this azab comes through wealth and also through sons and daughters. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ. Verily those who are in awe, who remain in awe for the fear of their Lord. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ. And those who believe in the signs and revelations of their Lord. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِرَبِّهِمْ لَا يُشْرِكُونَ. And those who do not associate anybody, anyone with their Lord. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا. And those who give what they give, whatever they spend. وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ. And their hearts are full of fear. أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. That they are going to return to their Lord. أَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَىٰ. Whosoever keeps fearing that a day will come when he will have to stand before his Lord for this accountability. So that person, you know, and he restrains the lusts of his nafs. نَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ. Well, for him is the Jannah. أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَهُمْ لَهَا سَابِقُونَ. These are the people who are racing with each other for good deeds, virtues. And they are the foremost in these things. وَلَا نُكَلِّفُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. We are not going to hold responsible any soul except according to its capacity. We know every person, every human being, what we have given him. What were the genes with which his body was formed? What were the environments in which he was living? Where he was born? In China or Japan or Hindustan or where? What was the environment where he was raised? Keeping all these factors in view, then we shall judge them. How much good he could do in these circumstances. If he has attained it, okay, he is successful. If he fails, he fails. But you know, there is not one standard for all the human beings, no. Because different human beings, they have been born and they have been created with different backgrounds, different genes, and they have been brought up in different environments. They have different educations. All these things will count. And keeping all these factors in view, Allah will then judge between the peoples. لَا نُكَلِّفُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. We shall hold responsible every soul, but only up to the capacity. وَلَدَيْنَا كِتَابٌ يَنْتَقُ بِالْحَقِ. And we have the record which tells everything truly. He knows what genes were given to me. He knows it. They are recorded. وَهُمْ لَا يُزْلَمُونَ. And they will not be wronged. بَلْ قُلُوبُهُمْ فِي غَمْرَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا. But the hearts of these people, they are covered and blind about these things. وَلَهُمْ أَعْمَالٌ مِّنْ دُونِ ذَلِكَ. And they are busy in some other types of activities. Luxuries and, you know, enjoying. And just بَابَرْ بَعَشْ كَوْشْ كَيَالَمْ دُبَارَ غِيسْتْ. هُمْ لَهَا عَامِلُونَ. They are busy in these things. حَتَّى إِذَا أَخَذْنَا مُتْرَفِيهِمْ بِالْعَذَابِ. Till that time that when we seize the affluent among them with our chastisement, إِذَا هُمْ يَجْعَرُونَ. Then they begin weeping and mourning and groaning. لَا تَجَرُوا الْيَوْمِ. Allah will say, no mourning and groaning today. إِنَّكُمْ مِنَّا لَا تُنْصَرُونَ. Now nobody can come to your help against us. You have to bear everything. قَدْ كَانَتْ آيَاتِ تُتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ. My ayat were recited to you. قَدْ كَانَتْ آيَاتِ تُتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ فَكُنْتُمْ عَلَىٰ عَقَابِكُمْ تَنْكِسُونَ. But you used to turn away on your heels and go away and then listen to my ayat. مستكبرين in arrogance. بِهِ سَامِرًا تَحْجُرُونَ. And you used to talk about it mockingly during the night. أَفَلَمْ يَدَّبَّرُ الْقَوْلِ. Do they not ponder over this, what has been said to them? أَمْ جَاهُمْ مَا لَمْ يَأْتِ آبَاهُمُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. Or the matter is that to them has come what did not come to their forefathers. This is an apology for these people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is presenting. Because these people, these Quraysh, these progeny of Ismail, they had no prophet, no messenger, no book for more than 2,000 years. So they became absolutely unaware of these things. A thing has come to them which didn't come to their forefathers. أَمْ لَمْ يَعْرِفُوا رَسُولَهُمْ. Have they not been able to recognize their messenger? فَهُمْ لَهُ مُنْكَرُونَ. And that is why they are denying him. أَمْ يَقُولُونَ بِهِ جِنَّةٌ. Do they say that he is possessed by a jinn? Or he has some, you know, mental disturbance? بَلْ جَاءَهُمُ الْحَقِّ. No. حق, the truth has come to them. وَهُمْ أَكْسَرُهُمْ لِلْحَقِّ كَارِهُونَ. And most of them abhor this truth. وَلَوِ اتَّبَعَ الْحَقُّ أَهْوَاهُمْ. And if the truth had followed their lusts and their wishes and their desires, لَفَسَدَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ, then the heavens and the earth would have been corrupted. وَمَنْ فِيهِنَّا, and whatsoever is within them. بَلْ أَتَيْنَاهُمْ بِذِكْرِهِمْ. But we have brought to them their admonition, their zikr, reminding for them. فَهُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِهِمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. But they are from their admonition and reminding, they are turning away. أَمْ تَسَلُهُمْ خَرْجًا. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are you asking some tribute from them? Do you ask for some rewards? You should pay me this salary, I am doing this service to you. أَمْ تَسَلُهُمْ خَرْجًا فَخَرَاجُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ. The tribute that your Lord will pay to you is much better. You are not asking them any tribute, any wage. وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. And definitely, Allah is the best provider. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. And O Muhammad, you are calling them to the right path. وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ عَنِ الصِّرَاطِ لَنَاكِبُونَ. And those people who don't believe in the hereafter, actually they are deviating from the right path. وَلَوْ رَحِمْنَاهُمْ وَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِمْ مِنْ ضُرٍّ لَلَجُّوا فِي طُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ. And if we had mercy on them, and we had removed the affliction that is upon them, they would persist in their insolence, wandering blindly. وَلَقَدْ أَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْعَذَابِ. And we have seized them with the punishment. Maybe during at the time when these ayat were revealed, some small affliction was there to the Makki people, just like a famine. You know, it has been the practice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever He sent a messenger to a people, then He sent some hardships, some small chastisements, so that they may be, if they are sleeping, they may wake up. So these are the, you know, things which have been coming before the final annihilation, that is Azab al-Akbar. This ayah is there in Surah Usaidah. وَلَنُزِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ. Before that great chastisement, when they will all be washed off from the surface of the earth, these small chastisements we have been sending, so that perchance they wake up from their slumber. وَلَقَدْ أَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْعَذَابِ فَمَسْتَكَانُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ. We have seized them with chastisement, but they humbled not for their Lord. وَمَا يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. And they are not invoking with submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حَتَّى إِذَا فَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَابًا زَعَبَادٍ شَدِيدٍ. Till that time, when we open for them the door of a very severe chastisement, إِذَا هُمْ فِيهِ مُبْلِسُونَ, then they become absolutely despaired and disappointed in it. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم. ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.